Hello, this is Connie Belden, and in this video we're going to take some journal entries and we're going to learn how to post them to the ledgers and then how to balance our ledgers. So let's assume we have the following journal entries. Remember, the first one's your debit followed by your credit. So let's assume the first journal entry on January 2nd was a debit to cash for $1,000 and a credit to common stock. Okay, so let's go to the cash ledger. Each account has its own individual ledgers. This is the first entry in the cash ledger, so we'll put the date. You can leave the item place blank. Now, for post reference, we're going to assume that all of our journal entries are on page 1. So post reference will be 1 in all of our ledgers. Okay, and then I will debit cash for $1,000. Since I have no other previous entry, I now have a debit balance of $1,000 in cash as well. Now, I also need to credit common stock. So I will come down here to the common stock account, put January 2nd. Again, I'll put post reference 1. We're going to assume all of these journal entries are on page 1 of our journal. And it is a credit of $1,000. And since there's no previous entry, it will be a $1,000 balance. Now notice the ledgers have account numbers. Cash is 11, common stock is 31. So after we post them, we come back to the journal, and in the post reference column of the journal, we put the ledger account number. That signifies that we have posted it and we are done. So again, the post reference in the ledgers is the journal page number. The post reference in the journal is the ledger number. Okay, next, debit cash, credit fees earned for $300. Okay, so I'll put the third, again, journal page 1, debit cash for $300. Now, for the balance column, don't just bring over the $300. Okay, you have a $1,000 debit balance and a $1,000 debit entry. When you have two debits, you go ahead and add them together and then keep it on the debit side. So your balance is $1,300. Again, this is account number 11. So I will fill in 11 next to cash for post reference. And then I'll credit fees earned for $300. So I will come to the fees earned account, put January 3rd, post reference 1, and credit for $300. Since that's the only entry so far, it will have a credit balance of $300. It's account number 41. So for post reference, I'll fill in 41. Next entry, debit account receivable, credit fees earned for $400. So on January 4th, post reference 1, debit for $400, account receivable. No previous entry, so it has a debit balance. That's account number 12. I'll post it in the journal here in just a moment. Okay. And then the credit was to fees earned for $400. So I'll come down here to fees earned, put in the fourth, page 1, and it was a credit of $400. Now remember when we had two debits, we added those together? Same thing is true if you have two credits. You would add them together. So in this case, I have a credit balance of $300 and a credit entry of $400. So I now have a credit balance of $700. Okay, and the account number is 41. So I will come back. I will fill in 12 and 41, the account numbers. Okay, next on the 5th, I will debit supplies and credit cash for $100. Okay, so let's go to supplies. Post reference 1, we're still on journal page 1. Okay. And the amount of supplies was $100. Just double checking. No previous entry. So the balance is also a debit of $100. Now, the supplies were bought with cash. So I will go to the cash account, fill in the 5th, post reference 1. Now remember, it was a credit for $100. So now this is new to us. We have a debit balance of $1,200 and a credit entry. If you have the opposite, if you have a debit balance and a credit entry, then you need to subtract and take the difference. Since the debit number is larger, it will stay on the debit side. So $1,300 debit balance minus $100 credit entry gives me a balance of $1,200, which would make sense if we had a $1,300 balance. We paid cash out for $100 worth of supplies, so now our balance is $1,200. Okay, we'll fill in the post-reference of 14 and 11. 14, 11. Okay, on the 6th, we paid some cash dividends. Dividends is debited for $200. Cash is credited for $200. Okay, so let's go to dividends. Put January 6th. Post-reference 1. It is debited for $200. No previous balance. So debit balance of $200. Now, the credit then, and by the way, that is account number 32. So go ahead and fill that in. And our credit is to cash for 200. So I'll put the 6, post-reference 1. Make sure to put it on the credit side. Now again, you have a debit balance of 1200 minus the credit entry of 200. Your credit entry is subtracted, but it still stays on the debit side because the debit number was higher, so now your balance is 1,000. Okay, and I'll fill in account number 11. Our last one, we received some cash on account, so we're debit account receivable and credit AR. So on the 7th, again, we're still on journal page 1. I will debit cash for 250. So now I have a debit balance and a debit entry, so add them together. Again, you got to keep a continuous balance. You have to balance after every transaction in that balance column. Okay? And that's account number 11. And then credit account receivable for 250. So again, journal page 1, put 250 on the credit side. Now, here's an example where you have a debit balance and a credit entry. You have opposite. So plus 400 minus 250. The 400 is larger, so you stay on the debit side. So your balance in AR is 150. Okay, and I will put account number 12 next to it. Okay, so I hope this helped you out with posting journal entries to ledgers and balancing your ledgers. Again, make sure you always keep a continuous balance after every transaction. Thank you very much.